Honorable Chief Guest, Professor D.P. Singh, Chairperson, University Grant Commission, Government of India. Dr. Tuo Sui In, Member Governing Body Board from Asia Pacific Center of Education for International Understanding. Mr. Eric Font, Director, UNESCO, New Delhi. Major Harsh Kumar, Secretary, NCERT. All the dignitaries from UNESCO, other international bodies, delegates from Nepal, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, Bhutan, and Maldives, and my dear colleagues from different departments of NCERT and different constituents of NCERT. I would like to welcome you all to this sub-regional meeting on integrating SDG 4.7 on global citizenship education into teacher training in South Asia. I feel privileged to be here on this auspicious occasion. For the first time, we are holding a meeting with the South region, South Asia countries, and all the representatives are there. We are really grateful to UNESCO for providing this opportunity. Of course, we are doing in collaboration, but the lead, UNESCO has taken lead and we have provided support, and I hope we have been successful in achieving our goal. You know, we are organizing this program in NCERT. NCERT stands for National Council of Education, Research and Training. It has 8 constituents units all over the country. Here, you are sitting here, this is the Central Institute of Educational Technology, one of the constituent unit of NCERT. The other building is National Institute of Education, where we have 18 departments relating to school education. And we have another central institute on vocational education that is located in Bhopal, and 5 regional institutes of education. They are the model teacher education institutions in the country. And all these constitutes NCERT. And you will be happy to know that in teacher education program, we are going to introduce this global citizenship education as one of the papers. This is going to be implemented in all universities of the country. Government of India has taken initiative. Because since long, for last 50 years, we have been running this BSc B.Ed, B.A. B.Ed integrated program in our regional institutes of education. But now Government of India has taken decision to implement, replicate this program all over the country. And you'll be happy that global citizenship education is going to be one of the papers in pre-service teacher education program, where all our pre-service teachers will be familiar with this idea, this concept, and also they will know about the implementation. India has a very rich tradition. We believe in Vasudeva Kutumbakam. We call the whole world as one family. Whole world as one family. This is from ancient India, and we have been propagating this. Our Honorable Prime Minister is putting a lot of emphasis on this. Vasudeva Kutumbakam, treating whole world as one family. And India has been trying to promote peace and understanding between nations. Now, our role is to achieve this goal through education. We have developed national policy on education. And in national policy, these core values are reflected. Democracy, egalitarianism, socialism, secularism, and observance of small family norm, protection of environment, equality of sexes, removal of social barriers, all these have been reflected in our national policy. And all these also have been reflected in our national curriculum framework, what we have developed. And all these have been reflected in our textbooks. It is not something new for us, because we have been trying our best to promote peace. Because we live in diversity, we have different language, different culture, and we have different tradition, but we are one, we learn from the beginning. And that we promote through education. And now, internationally, we live in a globalized world with unresolved political, social, economic, and environmental challenges. Only through education, we can resolve these issues, we can face these challenges, and we can promote peace and international understanding. We need right type of education. And this sustainable development and global citizenship education should be integrated in our education system. It is not that only in India we are doing, all the countries are trying their best. And in the curriculum, some elements of global citizenship education in the name of human rights, in the name of values, in the name of peace have been reflected. Now time has come, we have to see to what extent it has been reflected, what more we can do, how can we involve all the channels of education, formal, non-formal, and informal. How can we develop knowledge, skill, attitude, and values among the students? And it should be reflected in our policy, it should be reflected in our teacher education program, it should be reflected in our curriculum, it should be reflected in our assessment system. Then only we can achieve the goal. This is a big challenge for all of us. We have to live together. We have to promote peace. We have to promote international understanding. For that, we have to improve the quality of education, particularly teacher education. If we can improve the quality of teacher education, definitely we can improve the quality of education. That is why it is high time this should be integrated into the teacher education program. Our teachers should be oriented properly in the entire South Asia region so that they can take it to the grassroots, it will go to the classroom, and it will promote peace, harmony, and international understanding. We can live peacefully. With this objective, we are organizing this sub-regional meeting on this integrating SDG 4 and global citizenship education into teacher education. I hope all of you will enjoy this 3 days program. It will be very productive, very effective. It will be a very good learning experience. Once again, I take this opportunity to welcome all to this 3 days meeting. Thank you.